My name is Binayak, and I am the founder of social enterprise ThinkZone, which works towards improving the learning outcomes of children in low-resource settings. Today, I want to talk about shapelessness of learning. Well, one could wonder what the meaning of shapeless is. I ran a simple Google search, and this is what I found. Rather weird, isn't it? More than synonyms, they look like judgments. Disappointed? I move to this famous quote by Bruce Lee. Empty your mind, be formless, shapeless, like water. Like water. Contextual, adaptable, flexible. We keep this in the background and look at the current times. The pandemic has been significant in reshaping and reforming our ideas on what works and what does not, especially in solving multiple problems that we are facing as a society. And one such problem that has been spoken about a lot during the pandemic is the challenge that children face in learning. Just like the synonyms of shapelessness that has a preconceived negative connotation attached to it, the very definition of learning also has a lot of predefined ideas that again we have as a society. Today, I aim to try and reshape at how we look at learning in our lives today. Well, learning is like water, shapeless, contextual, and adaptable. Learning can be anywhere. But unfortunately, in the society, we think that learning, especially for young children, can only happen in a formal environment. It can only happen in schools or via textbooks. We sometimes overlook the fact that learning can happen from anywhere and everywhere. Has the pandemic made children unlearn what they have? Absolutely yes. Are millions of children not being able to get access to education? Absolutely yes. UNESCO has mentioned that more than 320 million children don't have access to education during the pandemic. World Bank has also mentioned that due to school closures, millions of children are not getting access to learning. With the pandemic, this mode of education shifted to a completely to an online mode. Children started attending classes, giving exams on smartphones or on their computers. But are all children getting access to education? No. Why? Because most children don't have smartphones. NSSO has mentioned that only 15% of the Indian households in rural India have internet, while only 42% in urban India have internet. While these statistics are alarming, it points to the fact that, especially with different modes of learning coming to an online mode, not all children are getting access to education. But is education and learning related? By definition, learning refers to an intellectual process of acquiring new skills and knowledge through experience, study, or teaching. Education, meanwhile, is an enlightening process of receiving and providing knowledge through systematic instructions. So by no means, education is merely a degree. Good education does not always mean good learning. So in no way we can say that a person who has a good degree is actually learning. This is the story of Gayatri from the village of Balabhadra Prasad in Odisha, where we at ThinkZone have been implementing our programs. With schools shut during the pandemic and no smartphone at home, studying looked like a very difficult option for Gayatri's child. And Gayatri does not have a formal education degree to boast of. In such a scenario, we would all wonder that Gayatri might not be serious about her child's learning. This is the story of Nityashi from the capital city of Bhubaneswar in Odisha. With the only child of her house, she attends a known school and whose parents have also enrolled her for online learning from a well-known company. Would there be any doubts in our mind that the parents of Nityashree don't care about her education? A good socioeconomic background, a good family background, would seem to realize us or make us understand that good learning is happening. But out of the two scenarios, where do you think learning is happening? This image of a beautiful classroom would symbolize words like qualified teacher, good grades, good learning, successful career. This image of a public school in a remote village would symbolize words like no learning, unskilled teacher, bad grades, etc. An excellent socioeconomic background, a good educational infrastructure would automatically seem to reflect that learning is happening. But if we knew that Gayatri was actually teaching her child at home, we would not associate it with learning. If we knew that a community learning center run by a passionate youth, Priyanka, is helping students make considerable gains in language and arithmetic, we would still not associate it with learning. I have had the opportunity to be working with some amazing people at ThinkZone. And at ThinkZone, our job is to highlight the fact that learning can happen anywhere. One does not require flashy things to bring about positive change or support children in their learning process. Innovation does not always have to mean bright, new, or shiny. It can be as simple as perfecting something which already works. Sometimes reinventing the wheel is not required. So instead of creating a new solution from scratch, we decided to support youth from local communities to becoming education leaders. These youth are not only passionate to do something of their own, but they want to create meaningful change in their societies. We have been working with thousands of youth by supporting them using a blended strategy of low-cost technology and an instructor-led support. And what we have seen is youth like Priyanka, who have been passionately trying and supporting children in her communities. No flashy models, no beautiful classroom, but significant learning gains. Learning is truly shapeless, isn't it? Again, irrespective of parents' education, if the right nudge is provided to them through localized solutions and low-cost technology, they very well can support children in their learning process. So we work with communities to support at-home learning using remote instructions via text messages and phone calls. And when these instructions lead to quality parental engagement, what comes to the realization is that learning for children can happen anywhere. What we tend to forget is that learning is much more than reading or writing. Learning could be children analyzing something, hearing something. And parents who don't have access to smartphones or the internet can very well support children in their learning process. Our belief has been best summarized by seeing actual positive change on ground and also through independent evaluations, which have found out that parents from low-resource settings can significantly impact their children's learning levels. These results have shown that children have made more than 20% learning gains in language and arithmetic. Because we often forget in our assumptions that while parents like Gayatri may not have a good education degree, or youth like Priyanka may not be from an elite college background, what they have are skills that have made them to survive. If we provide them with the right nudge and support, they very well can support children in their learning process. We as a society have been continuously made to believe that a good socioeconomic background or good educational infrastructure is directly related to a good learning. But when we see the true stories of Priyanka and Gayatri, we are really confident that learning can actually happen anywhere. That makes learning a truly adaptable, flexible, contextual, and shapeless process, just like water. With this, I hope I've been able to make everyone understand the true meaning of learning and how much important it can add value to our all lives. Thank you.